Isn't he beautiful, beautiful, isn't he, Prince of Peace, Son of God, isn't he?
Church grows spiritually or by numbers, the one who dislikes most is Satan. So always disturbs people's mind. So you have to always be ready to confront such a deceitful spirit. Always try to destroy us, destroy the church. So be ready. Okay. I'll make it short. 5 minutes. Bear with me, 5 minutes. I'm lying to you. Okay, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 1 and 8. Preach the word. Preach the word. That is the title of question is, what is our goal of life on earth? If our goal of life on earth is just to receive the blessing from God, meaning the blessing means happiness, right? Happiness. In fact, it means happiness. If people just want to receive blessing from God, I think we'd better just have faith. Doing nothing, you just do nothing, just have faith. And we truly believe in Jesus Christ, and we truly believe we have received life eternal through our Lord Jesus Christ. But is that all? Is that all? We just have to receive the grace and love from God. Do nothing. And last thing, I wondered why Jesus said in Matthew chapter 10, let's look at the verse, look at 10, Matthew 10, verses 38, 39. And Jesus said to his disciples, the 12 disciples, "He who does not take his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. He who has found his life shall lose it, and he who has lost his life for my sake shall find it." Shall find it. Here Jesus is talking about sacrifice. Sacrifice. We must offer sacrifice. We are not worthy of. We are not worthy of. We are not worthy of Jesus Christ if we ask God only for more blessing. Don't we do that? I mean, we always, every time we pray to God, "Bless me. God blesses me, please. God blesses me, please." We always ask God more blessings, more blessings. But here Jesus is asking us our sacrifice. Take your cross and follow Jesus Christ. Well, today the Bible says, Apostle Paul, let's look at verse 1. I solemnly charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus. I charge you something. What is this? What is Paul is talking about? Jesus is the judge. He will judge the living and the dead, the quick and the dead. And he will come to judge the world, judge the quick and the dead. He will establish the kingdom of God. I solemnly charge you in the presence of God and Christ Jesus. What is he talking about here? God has not called us just to give us blessings. That's the conclusion, actually. Because God just wants to give us happiness, he has called us. May never be. He has called us because he wants to fulfill our mission. In Acts chapter 1, verse 8, let's look at it. Jesus commanded this. Let's read together. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea and Samaria, and even to the remotest part of the earth. This was the commandment before Jesus ascended to heaven. God has not just called us to just have faith, but also he has called us to fulfill mission, to spread the gospel. So verse 2 says, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 2 said, Preach the word of God. Be ready in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with great patience and instruction. Preach the word of God. Why? Because the words of God are able to give us the wisdom. What is this wisdom? Like becoming a smart man? No. This wisdom is that lead us to our salvation. That is the wisdom. Wisdom leading us to our salvation. So the words of God, the Bible teaches us the way to our salvation. The Bible, the words of God also condemns our sins for repentance. That is reproving, rebuking. It condemns our sins for our repentance. The words of God. Also exhorting, encourages us to practice good works. And also with great patience and instruction, meaning that the words of God keeps us our faith, even under great difficulties or tribulations. And also instruction. The words of God guide us to become an honorable and praiseworthy Christian in the world. That is how the words of God function. So be ready in season and out of season. Preach the word of God. Are you ashamed of the gospel of God and Jesus Christ? Are you ashamed? We are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, because it is the power. It is the power of God who gives us life eternal. Verse 3 said, then why we have to preach the word of God? Because the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, or wanting to have their ears tickled. They will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance to their desires, and will turn away their ears from the truth, and will turn aside to myth. So time is evil. As Jesus prophesied already in Matthew chapter 24, there will be many false prophets, many false teachers, false doctrines. And these false teachers or prophets teach something very strange gospel. I want to give you some example. Many pastors, many preachers only preach about moral conduct, morality among people. Many preachers and teachers only teach about how you can become rich, how you would be blessed. They only teach those things. Some of them never teach about God and Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. They don't teach them at all. That is the false and very strange gospel. Think about it. So somehow when you leave this church and go some other very far away, please find the church and find pastor who only preach the gospel of Jesus Christ and God and Holy Spirit, the Trinity of God. Whoever teaches the Bible, just go to that church. Do not go to those churches who only preach about your morality, moral conduct among people. They just teach about how you become happy. No. Don't ever go there. Please listen carefully to the words of God. They are the false prophets, false teachers. They are teaching false doctrines. Micah chapter 3, verse 5 says, he was a prophet in the Old Testament. Through Micah the prophet, God said, thus says the Lord concerning the prophets who lead my people astray, when they have something to bite with their teeth, they cry, peace. But against him who puts nothing in their mouth, they declare holy war. I don't want to talk about me, but whenever I preach in other places, right, and they always try to pay money, but I say, no, I do not preach for money. I just give it back. Because I don't preach for money. I'm trying to preach the life. But why should I? Because I have received life from God as a gift. But why should I get paid when I preach life, right? It was a gift. It's a free. It was free to me. And I should charge somebody? No, I never do that. But God prophesied in the last days there will be false teachers and false prophets. They preach for money. Don't follow these people, right? Don't follow these people. They are the false prophets, false teachers. On the other hand, somehow, members of the church come to church, and they come to church because they hear something that tickles their ears, because they want to hear something that please their eyes, satisfy their weary mind. If it looks good for food, pleasant to the eyes, desirable to make us wise, they listen to those sermons, those preachings. So we become dull to the truth, the sound doctrine. We want to just hear something pleasant, something desirable for our desire of the flesh. People always come to church to try to listen to some funny joke. So don't go to that church. Don't go to that kind of church. I'm sorry to say that. Because I always tell you that the Bible is about the life and death. It's about the life and death. We have to be very serious about this matter. Alright? Verse 5, but you, time is evil. When there will be false prophets, false teachers, and people want to hear something that tickle their ears, make them feel happy without telling the gospel of Jesus Christ and God. But you, be sober in all things, meaning that we do not, as a Christian, we do not indulge the excessive desire of our flesh. That means sober in all things, right? We are not drunk with the excessive desire of our flesh, we do not love the world more than we love God. That means sorrow in all things. Endure hardship, of course. Of course, we have difficulties because sometimes I'm a Christian. Sometimes people, persecute me. Yeah, they persecute me. But we endure those kind of hardships. Also, you guys work 10 hours a day in the hot, scorching sun. You got all sweat every day. That's the kind of hardship we endure. All the difficulties and persecutions, we endure and do the work of an evangelist. That is our ministry. Become an evangelist. Preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Preach Jesus, our Lord, Savior. That is our ministry, and God wants us to fulfill this ministry. To fulfill this ministry, to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Verse 6 says, "For I am already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time of my departure has come." At this time, when Paul wrote the letter to Timothy, Timothy was a pastor in Ephesus, Ephesus, yeah. But he sent a letter to Timothy when he was in Rome. He knew he was about to die. That's why he wrote this way, "I'm already being poured out as a drink offering." He knew he was about to die, executed by Romans. The time of departure has come. Time of departure. Now, when the Paul said a drink offering, this meaning sacrifice. Sacrifice. Apostle Paul was fully against Jesus Christ. He even brought the Christians to execution. But suddenly he converted to Christian. On the way to Damascus, he saw the vision and he heard the voice of Jesus Christ, and he converted to Christians. Now he became a Christian and an apostle to Gentiles. He made 4 times a mission trip, and he established churches, and he sacrificed his rest of his life. He offered himself a drink, which is the sacrifice. He sacrificed himself. I want to ask you a question. Are you taking your cross? Are you taking your own cross and follow Jesus? How much sacrifice have you offered for the sake of Jesus Christ? This is my question to myself either, also. Another question is, are we ready to meet with God? Are you ready? Am I ready? Just ask yourself, am I ready? The time of my departure has come. Nobody knows when to die. And are you ready? Am I ready? Ask yourself, am I ready to meet with God? And the apostle said now, verse 7, "I have fought a good fight. I know I'm going to die, but I have fought the good fight. I have finished the course. I have kept the faith." People in the world fight for their happy life. They fight for their happy life. But we as a Christian have another fight, which is the spiritual fight. Spiritual fight against the devil. This is not just a one day fight. This is lifetime spiritual fight against the devil. So at the end of our pilgrimage, can we just gladly say, "Yes, I have fought the good fight. I have kept my faith." Can we say that? You know, we shall all stand before God, before the presence of God and Jesus Christ. We'll all stand before him. And we have to ask ourselves, are we ready? Are we ready to meet with God? Even though God has called us and given us a mission to preach the gospel, the good news of the kingdom of God, have we really sincerely sacrificed for the sake of Jesus Christ? Let us ask ourselves for this week. Verse 8, now Paul knew that in the future there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have loved his appearing. So whoever, in the revelation we have done before, in the revelation, whoever overcome the temptation of the world, whoever keeps his faith, shall receive the fruit, the crown of life, the fruit from the tree of life, the crown of life. Remember, the name of God will be on our forehead. New name. We shall all have a new name. And the crown of righteousness, we shall receive a word,
Amen.
Or reward,
Amen.
From Jesus Christ. And we know Jesus is coming. One day he will come. We are waiting for his coming. One day Jesus will come to judge the quick and the dead, the living and the dead. And we shall all receive the reward, our life eternal. Life eternal. Let me conclude. People eat and drink, get married, without knowing God and Jesus Christ. Without knowing Jesus Christ, who will come to judge the world. If God really has called us, if we believe that we are all children of God, God has not called us just to have faith. Do nothing, just have faith. Is it so? May never be. God has called us to fulfill the mission. Spread the gospel. Spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. That is our mission to fulfill. But also we must remember, when we preach the gospel, we must expect there will be lots of persecution. And many difficulties we will confront. Because, for example, many false prophets, false teachers have come out. They teach some very strange gospel. Very strange gospel. Do not follow them. Do not follow them. So, we have the lifetime spiritual fight against the ruler of this darkness, the devil. We have a lifetime spiritual fight against the devil. So let us ask ourselves, are you ready? Am I ready to meet with God after we have finished our course? Am I ready? Are you fighting a good fight against the devil? What can you say about our life at the end of our pilgrimage? Today, God wants us to fulfill the mission. God has not called us to receive only the grace and love. No, God has called us to fulfill the mission. Preach the gospel. Preach the word of God. That is our mission to accomplish. It is the God's purpose of calling us. Thank God. At least I have a mission. You have a mission.
Mm-hmm.
And I truly, truly urge you to go out there. And when you meet people, preach the gospel. Let's preach the gospel. You don't have to preach like me. You don't have to preach like me. No. Just say, tell them about Jesus Christ. Tell them about God. God loves you. God loves you. It is not only my mission, but all of you have received this mission. Preach the word of God. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your message today. And you have not only given us the grace and love, but also you have given us a mission to fulfill. Although we can confront many difficulties and persecutions, we shall boldly preach the gospel. Because you have given us a gift of life eternal, we shall also give the life to those who are not believing in God and His Son Jesus Christ. It is our mission. Give us the strength to preach the gospel even to the end of the earth. I bless all your children who have come to worship. And remember that we only rely on you. We only trust in you. Please be with us. Be with us. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.